Okay, shalom aleichem.
Aleichem v'al v'alechem.
Those who are at home and here. This Shabbat, Parashat Toldot. Parashat starts with Toldot Yitzchak ben Avraham, Avraham ulei Yitzchak. And then, said the Parashat, Vayi Yitzchak ben 40 shana, Yitzchak was 40 when he took Rivka. And then the Torah said, Bekachto et Rivka, Bat Betuel Arami, Padan Aram, Achot Lavan Arami lo Lisha. So the Torah started to describe who was Rivka, the daughter of Betuel Arami from Padan. She was the sister of Lavan Arami. He took her to wife. And why? Last parasha, Lechai Sarah, we heard the story of Eliezer twice. Once the Torah told us, and the other story is Eliezer say himself. And he say in a long story. Who was Rivka? Where he was? Daughter of who? Sister of who? What was all the story? Why you say it again? Yitzchak ben 40 shana, v'kachtot Rivka. Yitzchak was 40 when he took Rivka because he wanted only to do a short overview before we come to speak about the descendants of Yitzchak and Rivka. So why you say v'kachtot Rivka, bat betuel ha'arami, v'achot lavan? Say the Midrash, כשושנה בין החוכים כן רעייתי בין הבנות. Like a lily between, yeah, so we said in Midrash according to this pasuk, like a lily between thorns, about who is speaking, so the Midrash say about
Rivka. The lily and the thorns are
Rivka, she was tzadikah, she was our mother, the wife of Yitzchak, it's not simple, it's the wife of this great man. And what, where she go up? So we will think someone is tzaddik. Of course, his father, and we are tzaddik too, like Yitzchak. His father, Avraham Avinu, the great man, the our forefather, and of course, his son is Yitzchak. No, say the Midrash not like this. Even someone that grew up in the worst environment, her father was Betuel. Her brother, as we're going to see in the next few parashot, was the worst, was a Ramai, a cheater, a worship idols. And what she become? Shoshana, a lily. She grew up in this environment and she became the wife of Yitzchak. So the Torah come and tell us that it's not that you can, no, I grew up like this, I did the education. No, if you want, you can be whatever you want. And we can see there, in the Psukim, after all the story with Eliezer, the servant of Abraham, and then he said, okay, you want to take Rivka? Let's ask her. Nikra la ne'ara v'nishala et piya. Let's call to this daughter and ask her. And she, and they, what you say? You will go with this man, but Tomer, Elech, I will go. So Rashi explained, what is Elech? I will go, okay. Rashi explained, Me'atzmi. I will go because I want. Even if you don't want, I will go. Why? Because I'm the one that decide for my wife, for her life. I'm the one who make a decision. I make a decision to be a tzaddikah, to be a righteous woman. I will be. Even if you don't want, and even if you raise me in this environment with this brother, with this father, with these neighbors, no, I want to be this. I see myself like this woman, so this is what I'm gonna be. So this is the reason that the parasha tell us again. But Rivka, Bat Betuel Arami, she was the daughter of Betuel, the sister of Lavan Arami. That Lavan Arami, we're gonna see in the next parasha. Chazal says, it's Lavan Arami. Why it's called them Arami? Because Arami is the same otiot, same letters of Ramai. Ramai is a cheater. So Lavan, he was Ramai. So we see, but Betuel Arami, of course, if her father was Arami, so her brother was also Arami, in the same family, in the same city. They say, no, he is Arami from Aram, but he also Ramai, was a cheater, Ramai, Lavan. So this is the reason that he say once again, who was the siblings of Rivka, and now we can understand from where she came and what she become. The same thing, we can say the opposite. Don't think that if your father is so tzaddik, that you'll be tzaddik like him. In the same parasha with Rivka, we read about Esav. To Rivka and Yitzchak, they have two sons, twins, Yaakov and Esav. Yaakov was Ishtan Yoshev Oalim, sit in the tent and learn Torah. But Esav, Ishtzai Ishtzadeh, always hunt, and the Midrash will describe a lot of worse things that he did, a lot of sins that he did. He's the son of Yitzchak and Rivka, the grandson of Abraham and Sarah. Don't think that everything will be okay because of your family. Don't trust anyone, trust yourself. If you want, you can be tzaddik like Rivka and Yaakov. If not, if you don't work for yourself, you can be a rasha like Abraham. Yitzchak took Rivka when he was 40 years old, and then 20 years that Yitzchak and Rivka didn't have a children. So the pasuk said, the next verse say, "Vayetar Yitzchak la'Adonai lo chishto ki akarai, vayater lo Adonai, v'tar Rivka ishto." Say the pasuk that Yitzchak prayed to Hashem in front of his wife because she was a barren woman, and what? Hashem answered his prayer, and she became pregnant. Say the Gemara say about this pasuk, this word. Shalom aleichem. The pasuk not say vayitpalel Yitzchak, and Yitzchak prayed to Hashem. What he say vayetar? So here I would explain vayetar in the same like pray. Yitzchak entreated. So here he used the word entreated vayetar, and not the word vayitpalel Yitzchak. Why? What different in here? So the Gemara say, "Lama nimshalat tefilatam tzadikim ke'atar?" Why the tefillah, the prayer of tzadikim, is we compare it to atar? Atar is the tool that we use in the field when you want to raise the straws and all the harvest. So to take it and to flip it outside down. So we use the atar. So why it's called vayetar from the word atar, from this tool? Because it says the same like this tool. We use it to flip it, to make it upside down. The same is the tefillah of tzaddik. The tefillah of a Jew can change the whole decree of Hashem. She was a barren woman and she prayed to Hashem in that way, entreated Hashem. So Hashem changed, so to speak, changed his mind. And gave them a child, gave them the Yaakov and the son. Now in this pasuk, when I speak on this pasuk, ask Rabbeinu Bechaye, yask vayetar Yitzchak la'Hashem nochach ishto ki akarai. Say Yitzchak entreated Hashem for his wife because she was a barren woman. Say it's not the way that you need to speak. First you need to speak what was the problem, and then we prayed and we had the solution. The same like in Sarah. In Sarah, "Vatehi Sarah yakara en lavalad." First of all, he said that Sarah was a barren woman. And then they prayed to Hashem, and Hashem gave them a son. Here he said, no. "Vayetar Yitzchak la'Hashem." Yitzchak entreated Hashem, he prayed to Hashem. Why? "Ki akarai." Say, "Vatehi Rivka akara." If Rivka was a barren woman, therefore, Yitzchak entreated Hashem. Said about the Rabbeinu Bechaye something fascinating. Say that as the Torah come here to tell us that tefillah, it's not a solution. It's not that you have a bad life, God forbid, you lost the money, you are sick, you have some. No, it's not a solution. Now I'm sick, so I'll pray to Hashem. I don't have money, so I'll pray in order to have money. Say no. Tefillah, it's not a solution. Tefillah, it's a goal. Tefillah, it's something that It's the first thing that we need to do even before we even had the problem. It's not that now we get a problem, okay, let's pray. No, prayer is something that we need to live in that way of prayer. So the Torah come and tell us, Vayetar Yitzchak LaHashem Nochach Ishto. Yitzchak, pray to Hashem. Yidabe. And then, Akarai, okay, so we're gonna pray also because for our children. But before this, Vayetar Yitzchak LaHashem, Yitzchak, and pray to Hashem, we pray to Hashem. First of all, before everything. The Hasidut, we explain, Tfilah, what is the word Tfilah mean? So we translate Tfilah to prayer. But Tfilah in Hebrew, what is the word Tfilah? Tfilah is come from the word Tafel. What is Tafel? Tafel is something that you don't have anything for himself. For example,
you can't tafel.
It's the same like, yeah, you have Tfilah. So you have the main thing and you have something that follow it. So we say that Tfilah, it's for us to be in Tafel to Hashem. For us to be to make ourselves as nothing compared to Hashem. Because when we pray, what we say? Even the biggest businessman, you have a lot of money. What he say? Hashem, give me parnasa. What he's saying here? I can do nothing. Only you. So I am tafel to you. Next to you, I am nothing. So this is tefillah. The way of tefillah is not I need something. So I ask from Hashem. No, first of all, I say I'm nothing. Without him, I cannot do anything. I'm not exist without him. Now, after this, so Hashem, give me this and that, whatever I need. But even before I miss anything, before I need anything, before the problem, I will pray. And we can see. So sometimes we need things that we pray. But even when we not need, everything is Baruch Hashem, it's good. Parnasa, the Bariyut, all the family are good. Now let's see the prayer. If you pray the same, like when you need something, someone, God forbid, someone is sick in the hospital. So you pray with tears, you cry for him. If in the same way, in the same kavanah, you pray, even when you don't need something, just pray because you show you work. This is the work, the avodah shebalev. It's a way of serve Hashem. It's not only when you need something you daven. Even if you don't need, like we have shalosh three tefillot a day. We have shacharit, mincha, and arbit. Why? If I don't need something, give me to sleep. I want to sleep for in the night earlier. Why I need to come here 8:15? Give me to sleep. No, I said no. You daven even if you don't. And then, when you will need, the tefillah are going to be like the most usual thing that you're going to do. It's going to be obvious that you're going to pray for Hashem. Okay, and then just go to a quick summary, and we say that Yitzchak treated Hashem because of his wife. She was a barren woman, so Hashem gave them. She gave her a pregnancy, and then we know the story about Rivka when she was pregnant. Then the children inside she felt. So here says that the children. I gated within her. So she felt something strange in this pregnancy. So she came to ask Hashem. She went to the Bet Midrash of Shem and asked him. And then Hashem told her that you're going to have two children. And those two children, it's not only children, it's two nations that will come from her. It's Am Israel and Edom. Now, after Yaakov and Esau was born, so we know that Esau was the firstborn. So they had Esau, and Esau was a hairy man. That's why they call him Esau, like from the word Asui, he already made. The Yaakov, the second one, exited the womb after him and hold his heel. or disease. Therefore, the Torah says, Al ken kara shmo Yaakov. Therefore, he called them Yaakov, Yaakov from the word Akev. Akev is a hill. Okay, now they grew up. They now 15 years old. What's happening now? A big thing, a very sad thing. When they turned 15, Avraham Avinu, their grandfather, passed away. So Avraham Avinu was 175 years. When they was born, because he had Yitzchak when he was 100 years old. Yitzchak was 60 when Yaakov and Esav was born. Now, 15 years later, Abraham is 175 and he passed away. So the Torah tells us about Yaakov, that he made a lentil soup. And Vayavoy Samin Asadev Yaf. So Rashi explained why he made this, this soup, because of Yitzchak was aver, was a mourner now. So he made them a ma'achal avelim, something that we need to give to avelim to eat during the Shiva. Now Esav come from the field. We know Vayavoy Esav in Asadev Yaf. Esav came from the field, he was tired. Vayomer Esav el Yaakov, aleitenina min ha'adom, ha'adom hazeh, give me to eat from this red thing. Because I'm tired. Vayomer Yaakov, Yaakov say to Esav, sell me your right of the firstborn. Vayomer Esav, ina anochi olech lamut, I'm about to die. Why don't I need this right? Yeah. And then Yaakov tell them, swear to me, and he swear, vayim kored b'choratol Yaakov, and he sell his right of firstborn. Vayakov, and then the Torah said, Vayakov, he gave to Esav, lechem v'nezeh adashim, gave him bread and the lentil soup. V'yochal v'yesh v'yakov v'yesh. Oh. Yeah, so here, what is Esav? Let's go back a little bit. Esav asked from Yaakov for one thing. Al itenina min ha'adom ha'adom hazeh. Give me to drink, to eat from this red thing, from this lentil soup. But what Yaakov gave him?
Lechem.
Lechem lezeh adashim, bread and this soup. Why? Well, he asked you only for one thing, for this soup, and you give him bread too. So, on this question, what?
It's a seudah.
Yeah, but why in seudah? Is this rasha? Give him something that he wants. Take what you want, the bechorah, and go away. Why I need to give him my bread? Understand the question? Why? Yeah. And the Torah say, "Vayakom natan leesav lechem." Why lechem? Why bread? Give them the nezirat hashim, this lentil soup, and send them from here. So this answer, we're gonna understand it from a Gemara. There is a Gemara that say that matnat shchiv merah eina matana. If someone that is about to die, is very very sick, and he gives you something as a gift. He promised you something. Now, after he, Baruch Hashem, he become healthy and he gets back to himself, it's not called a matana. It's not called a gift, and he can take it back. Why? Because in this time he wasn't so clear. His mind wasn't clear. He was about to die, so he can give stuff for free that after he will regret on this. So, Zetik Mara, this is the halacha that if someone give it in this point. It's not called a matana. It's not called a gift. So now, Chazal said that Esav, when he came back, he was so hungry and so tired, that he was sick, he was about to die. Yaakov told them, give me your bechorad, your right of the firstborn. Why? Because Chazal explained that you want to serve Hashem in Bet HaMikdash. Because only the firstborn used to work in Bet HaMikdash before Chet HaEgel, and then it's moved to the Kohanim. But before it was the firstborn, so say Yaakov, I want this right, not this Rasha, Esav, that he will walk in Bet HaMikdash. So he wants from Esav this right of firstborn. And he know that if I will give to Esav this lentil soup, he will eat, and then he will be satisfied, and he will get back to himself and say, I promised you before, I can regret. It's not called a matana, why? Because I was in this situation that I was about to die. Because of this, Yaakov, Natan, Le'esav, Lechem. You want this lentil soup? Okay. You sent me for this? Yes. Take bread. Now you are healthy. Now you get back to yourself. Now take this land. After you clear with your mind, now you can regret after and say, no, I not mean for this. And we see that Esau did regret after. After the blessing of Yitzchak to Yaakov instead of Esau, Esau come and say, Achi kara shemo Yaakov. Therefore, this is the reason that he called him Yaakov. Not because of the he. Vayakven izeh pa'amayim. He took my right of firstborn and now he took my blessing. So we see that he regret on this. So Yaakov knew it before and he said, I don't want to regret. So I will do, I will give him to eat one more thing. And now he's not going to consider, as Shchiv Merah, he's not going to consider someone about to die. So then I can take his right.